today we're going to be cooking a whole pork loin. Baby back ribs and tenderloin all combined.
Hey folks, we want to make a big shout out to everybody at Memphis in May this weekend. Hell yeah, kicking ass. Big time world championship. Got all the trailers and stuff lined up again, ready to go. Now, we always got to start off our show. Get this out of the way this morning. Cook us a big 20-pound pork loin bone-in this morning. And it's really composed of a lot of different parts. You got the pork tenderloin is in there. That's the hardest thing to keep from drying out. But that pork loin goes down the backbone, it'll dry out too fast. This is tough. It's all tough. Really tough. You gotta get all this stuff together right here. See if we can light all this in one match. I'm not paying to go to no more contests and promote other people's business. If you want me to come film your contest or world championship or anything, you gotta pay. I ain't doing it. Spend my money to promote somebody else's business. I can't afford it. I'd like to do it, but I can't afford it. Like you get ready to start rolling in just a minute. Don't take that stuff long to. Alright, let me go get our huge pork loin. Here we go. There's two of them in a pack. We're only going to cook one today. I used to get these in packs of five when I owned my own store. Now, just like everything else, I got them in packs of four. You get less for more. You get less for more money. I think they're about 3 foot long. I'm definitely going to have to cut it in half to get it in the ugly drum smoker. This came from Save-A-Lot. They ordered 700 cases. Got the being a recipient of two of them. I can hear that royal oak popping and cracking in that chimney. That's a Weber chimney. You can buy it on BBQ Superstars. Okay, here we go. Pork loin. Big solid guy. That thing's heavy too. I'm gonna go put this one in the freezer. Be right back. Wow, what a picture. Look at that big bad baby. Okay, so what we got here, here's the tenderloin, here's the baby back ribs. This here at the end is a pork sirloin. We've done a bunch of those on the cooking show. And then right here is your main loin. These are the boneless, skinless pork loins that you buy when you buy that 10 or 12 pound pork loin. That's down one side of the backbone of a hog. That's just one part of what they'll be cooking this weekend at Memphis in May. Now, I think what we're going to start doing is, believe it or not, I don't think I'm not going to trim that fat cap off. It's going to make it cook too fast. The whole problem today is trying to keep this thing from getting tough. And believe me, brother, it will get tough very, very, very easily. So, I think all we're going to start off doing is injecting. And I'm going to build a hell of an injection this morning to put in this thing. So for an injection, well, I got to take this thing off. Silver skin or membrane off the I wish I had a cooker big enough to hold the whole thing. Wow, look at all that. There you go. Now I could get a knife and separate them off, but we're gonna cook this all in one piece. That's what it's about today. That fat cap is going to hold off a little bit of flavor, but it'll help keep it moist. It'll help hold that moisture in there, and I think that's more important today than doing a whole lot of trimming. Okay, so what we're going to start off doing is we're going to put us a can of Dr. Pepper in it. It's got a little cherry flavor to it. Just a little bit to drink. And then we're going to put in a can of peach nectar. And then we're going to put in about 3 ounces of Kickback Cove Moonshine. Honey whiskey. Really, this isn't honey flavor, it's honey whiskey. But you add honey in with that honey whiskey, it's going to be good, good. All right, I'm going to put us a whole cup of Butcher Open Pit Pork Injection. Put us a whole cup in there. Dr. Pepper will add a lot of sweet flavor to it. Pour this. Thanks. Smell that moonshine in there. And here, yeah, that's really a good way of mixing stuff. Pour it back and forth. Ooh, ooh, look at all that. What? Now, how in the world are we gonna inject it? Well, let's start off with the backside. We're gonna do a little backside attack. I'm gonna inject the ribs first. I'm getting a smaller injection now, smaller needle out. Man, I wish I had a chops. I've had three of them, but I gave them away every time. Now you're gonna run a television show when you give everything away. There you go. Got two or three of them blowing up at a time. Get right down in that tenderloin. We're gonna have to wrap it somewhere toward the middle of our cook. There's no way we can keep that open. I'm gonna inject right up under them, right up under the ribs. Turn this thing over. If a bone creates flavor, then we ought to have the best tasting pork loin in the industry. You want to form like a matrix. Go down this thing. Put as much in there as you can. right behind that bone. Right there. Different angles. Just a minute. Okay, I know I can't get the whole thing in, but I wanted to inject it, before I cut it in half to see if we could hit a pocket and see what it looks like. Putting pressure on the loin, so I'm forcing some of the rub out, so that ain't cool. But all you gotta do is break in bone. Break at one bone, really. Thank you. Yeah, I can fit them in the smoker. I might. Go ahead and hit it a couple more times. I know it all didn't come out, but just to make sure she's fully loaded. That might be one of the keys to injecting is inject it one time, let it sit about 15 minutes, and then inject it again.
Get time for some of that injection to dissipate throughout the muscle.
Okay, now the first thing we're going to do is put mustard on them. We're going to have to go a little MBN on these things. Okay, looking good. Well, for the first time in BBQ Superstars history, I'm gonna try to keep it down to 225. Don't have to. This thing will get tough quick. Since I'm going to stay down at 225, I am going to wrap them. So what's the first rub I'm going to start off with? What else? Big T swine grind. Uh-oh. Oh, yeah. Got to do that. Big T swan grind. And then we got down with it. One time there was this dude laying brick up there, one of our businesses. His daughter came out and she said, took him out there in a field, said something to him. And then he said, "Oh God. And then he was all right. How stupid was that? Okay, then the next one we're gonna put on. It's gonna be a shocker. Now, Suckle Buster Hog Waller would be a good one. But, Suckle Buster Hog Waller would be a good one, but, Victory Lane. Victory Lane. Sweet Pecan Rub. He's out there competing in Memphis in May. He did a special dinner for the folks in Memphis in May. And that sweet pecan rub is a hell yeah. It definitely is a hell yeah. Yeah, that's the first time I didn't do a big trim on a piece of meat, but these things here will get dry. We go to ripping off all the protection of that center cut meat. It's gonna get messed up quick, so. We got injection on it. We got plenty of rub on it. It's gonna do good. Formation of that bark. Okay, and we're gonna put a little Grateful Dead pork. Grateful Barbecue. It's named after the Grateful Dead. Charlie Hardaway. Hell yeah, Charlie Hardaway. He working on some big time rubs out there. We're gonna have to get him a little coat in here. Layer them flavors on here. Okay, last but not least, Tony Chatterman's Creole. We gotta put a little bit of that Cajun on here. Just a little something. Let me tell you something. right now. We're gonna run you on over to the smoker and put this one in. Start off with, there's a bone there. See that flat? I'm gonna set it down on that bone, get all the meat up top. Let that smoke get to it. The other half now. The other one, another piece was a small side. This is the big side. This thing here may as well be steak. That thing's huge on this end. So when them people buy bigger pork loins, they're buying this end instead of the other end. The other end's where this is the pork sirloin. This is the pork sirloin side. So once again, we're gonna start off with our swine grind. Look at that. Over here looking in the yard. Okay, we're going to start off with a swine grind. I think we might turn it over on the baby backs. This piece here has got the most baby backs on it. Swine grind hits that pork and interacts with it, the magic starts happening. It's called the Maillard reaction. There's them baby back ribs right there on that edge. We're digging up bones. We're digging up bones. Seven things that's better left alone. Resurrecting memories of love that ain't gone. next one on the back. Victory Lane, Nutty Pecan. So many things are better left alone. Keith Rawls, just a good guy, man. He's a pro. Pecan on here. All right, now let's get our Charlie Hardaway. Last but not least, Tony Chatterins. Gotta put a little Creole on everything. Gotta put a little Jay Lee's on everything. Jay Lee barbecue sauce. Number one in the world is ranked by Barbecue Superstar. Jay Lee. Some bark. We're gonna try to cook this thing till it's falling apart. Done. We're making it fall apart today. Bone in. Bone's supposed to add flavor to it. All right, let's load it on the grill. Smoker. We ain't grilling today, we smoking. Smoking. Today, I'm cooking for my family. Ooh, listen to that sizzle. Iron Man cookies, man. Yeah, I'm going to get just a little bit more Big T Swan grinder. Make sure there's no place I didn't get. Big T, dominant force. It's always the startup. Got to start with Big T. Okay, let's put the lid on it. We'll come back in 1 hour. -225 degrees. Okay, the big thing here to take away from this shot is the formation of a crust. You know, if you think about the science of cooking meat, smoking meat, the first thing that happens in the first stages of cooking is a crust is formed. Now, through the Maillard reaction, all that rub and mustard that we put on here melts. And then it joins together along with the surface of the meat, and it makes a crust. Now, moving this meat around excessively and stuff will break that crust. Now, the heat is causing all the fluid within that meat to come to the outside edge. So, as you can see right there, I didn't touch it, but there was a, had to have been a break in the crust, and some of that fluid leaked out. That's why we inject, because we want to add fluid. It'll all come to the outside edge of the meat to try to protect the meat from breakdown. And then it will stay there until we put it in the cambro, and it's able to equilibrate and let that heat go back to the center, which the center is going to get a certain amount of heat. But so we're doing perfect. Run along about 250. You can see at a slower temperature it doesn't put as much pressure on the meat. So we're going to close it up 250. We'll come back in 2 hours and we'll let it cook slow, low and slow. Oh yeah, looking good, low and slow. I don't usually cook this low, but these things will get tough. Now, one thing you can do is wrap it in bacon. You know, that's what they do in Memphis in May. They wrap it in bacon. Keep that moisture in. But if you cook it low and slow enough, you won't have any problems. We got a rib coming out right here. Looking good. Low and slow. All right, we'll come back in about an hour. See how it's going, how we're doing. Okay, we are back, and we're getting on into our cook now. We've been cooking now for 4 hours. The ribs on the baby backs are drawing up. We're cooking low and slow. And Going slow is a different animal. I might let it go another hour.
I don't think it's gonna hurt nothing.
Let's put another little bit of Charlie Hardaway Grateful Dead on it. Yeah, low and slow works good. Let's let it go another hour. 3 o'clock. We'll be back at 3 o'clock. That's a nice color on it. Run along. It's still not done. We better go ahead and wrap it. I better wrap it. I got that baby back ribs on there. I know they gotta be wrapped. I gotta get a new set of meat rakes. I lost one of my meat rakes. They make it a lot more convenient by moving meat around. Not breaking that crust. Pretty piece of meat, guarantee you. That's a pretty piece of meat. I gotta eat this, man. Can't hardly stand not to get that. Man, that's good. Gonna do one layer over the top instead of two. Save a little tinfoil. Here's our injection. I'm gonna pour some of that in there. There'll be plenty of juice coming out of the loin. As the cook goes along. Now this other loin is huge, man. I have to make it longer this time. longer piece than a nice spring breeze. Well, it sure has been beautiful this year. Now let's see, let's go get this other piece. I love you now, Mom. A lot of parts, a lot of pieces in together here. Definitely gonna have to rub. Gonna have to wrap that. Watch out, the fire gets too hot. Boy, man, that's nice looking. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna get a whole stick of salted butter. Don't like it. Cut it in half because it looked like it's a little high. Hopefully it won't wash all my rub off. That way it'll be on top of it. There, here we go. Got it. That's what it is right there. That's a great big piece, man. Now we're gonna put a little bit of you in there. And I'm gonna put a little bit more Kickback Cold Honey Moonshine in there. I have to take me a little nip. Man, that's some powerful stuff. Ooh, look at there, that boat. Fish. Yeah. So it don't leave. Okay, 2 hours. We're gonna be done. Right now, 3:12. In fact, at exactly 5:12, we should be able to cut it up and start eating. Floating along about 250.
I'll have to see if this thing's done or not.
been cooking for 8 hours. The fire's gonna help it. We'll see what's going in a minute. Juice is running out. That's the reason you got to put two rows of tinfoil up underneath of it, because it'll stick to the rack. And yeah, it's done. And rip. I guess that's what it just did. Josh. Don't rattle. One for me. One for Molly. Damn, she don't need any barbecue sauce on this. Thank you. Okay, we'll see you next time on Barbecue Superstars. Y'all have a good day.
Thanks for subscribing to the Barbecue Superstars cooking channel. We got a lot more coming.